Hello guys, welcome back. On the other day I was playing ACC and some of you asked me about my settings because the image quality was good. So I decided to create a video to show my settings. So I'll divide it in six like chapters. Okay, so basically I'll talk about my CPU, GPU, NVIDIA settings, Windows Mixed Reality settings, SteamVR settings, and finally about ACC. Okay. Okay, so I'll show you my CPU settings. I'm using Ryzen Master to overclock my CPU. And the default clock, it's 3800 megahertz. And I've changed it to 4675, okay? With the core voltage for 12.5 volts. Okay, I think this is enough. I could achieve more, but I don't want to stress my CPU any more than this because playing ACC, my CPU goes like in 60% of load while I'm streaming. Okay, so it's more than enough. So, yeah, I have a RTX 3090 from NVIDIA. It's the one from Gigabyte. It's a Gigabyte 3090 Turbo. It's a hell of a jet plane. I have to tell you, it's very loud. Don't buy it. Unless you don't have any other option as I had. So, yeah, I'll show my settings. I have on the core clock 100 and on the memory clock 300. That's it. I've just changed the fan settings. It's more aggressive now. I've changed it a bit. It's more for mining, not so for gaming, but I prefer to have good ventilation on it. Okay, so now on the NVIDIA settings. If you go to control panel, on program settings, here on power management mode, make it maximum performance, okay? It will use your GPU entirely. Then here, I've set it off. It's usually off, but yeah, put it off if it's not off on your PC. And the negative LOD bias to claim. And I was searching for that. And if you check what are the benefits of this is, it's like, if you have a stationary image, it will be more clear, okay? But if it's in motion, the image will be not so detailed. The thing is, most of the games, they use anisotropic sample optimization. There is a setting on ECC for that. And if you set it to clamp, you will have a better image. Those bars, white bars that you sometimes see on the game, some of them will disappear. So that's why I use clamp. And that's it for the NVIDIA control panel. Now on Windows Mixed Reality, if you go to settings, headset display, I've made the Mixed Reality Home the lowest settings possible. I don't want them to have any detail at all. Okay, for me it could be disabled, but yeah, low and 720p. Then on here on experience options, I choose optimize for performance. Why? Because we will not see the cliff here. Okay, so we can discard that extra GPU process, okay? So make it optimized for performance. Then on the resolution, best quality, you need to have best quality. And then I have it at 60 hertz. Most of the people prefer 90, of course, either do I, but the thing is, ACC is very demanding, and I'll use 60 hertz without reprojection, Okay, so all the frames are being processed. So 6 years for that. You can use reprojection. You can try it. You can use 90Hz with reprojection. But for me, it's not the same. The image is not so fluid. Okay, guys, now on the SteamVR definitions or settings. On general, or if you go directly to video, use 100%, okay? Don't use less than that, okay? Even for per application video settings. On Assetto Corsa Competizione, I'm using 100, okay? And motion smoothing disabled. You can enable it or force it to be always on. That's the reprojection, okay, for the game. So I don't use reprojection. I use 60Hz or 60 FPS on this case. Without reprojection, I prefer that because the image quality is better, and even the flow of the image for me it's the best option. You can try use 90Hz on Windows Mixed Reality and then enable Force Always On or enable it here. You will have like extra capacity for the GPU, but for me it's not so smooth as we did disabled. Okay, so make it 100, and I'll tell you why. The Unreal Engine, it's really good in upscaling the settings. Okay, so I prefer to lower the resolution on the game rather than on SteamVR. Okay, there is another thing. The lens. Okay, they are designed to see the resolution that is here. This is not a glitch. This is not a bug of the software. This is the resolution that you should play the game to have the best performance for the lens. Okay, so that's why you should always use 100% on the games. If the game does not have a way to lower the resolution, yeah, of course, you need to lower it here. Sorry about my English because I'm Portuguese. yeah. So that's all for the SteamVR settings. Under the game settings, if you go to video, I'm using... I could use lower resolution, but I'm using this to record my videos while I'm streaming, okay? But you can lower it. It will give you more GPU for the headsets and less for the monitor, okay? Then the VSync, it's disabled. You don't need it to run on your headset. No frame rate limit. Yeah, on the menu, triple screens, I don't use it. So, now here. As I told you, the resolution scale, I lowered it a lot here in game because the Unreal Engine is really good to upscale the image. So I'm using the lowest possible. Okay, and there is another thing that I'll tell you before, but I'm using the lower possible because what makes the difference now? I'm not running the game on VR because I think I cannot record the settings on VR. Here on pixel density, I'm not using 100. I'm using 150%, okay? Because the pixel density creates much more clear image than the resolution. So I prefer to have 50% on the resolution and 150% on the pixel density. Okay, so then everything on medium, most of them, view distance, shadows, shadow distance, contact shadows, okay. To be honest, I didn't try this one. I have to try it, but I think it's like when you see the cars floating, that type of shadow or this contact shadow will create a more clear or more real image. Then detailizing, use it at high or epic, okay? Don't use lower than that to create a messy image, like a blurry image. And then I've tried several types of anti-aliasing. The one for me is temporal. Okay. There are some guys that says KTAA are the best one. For me, it's not. Temporal is the best one because you want to focus on the horizon. Okay, you want to have a clear picture on the horizon. The temporal is the best one. This one is more blurry. You can see better the things around you, but while you're driving, you are trying to focus on the horizon. So keep it temporal. The effects I have on high, because I like to see the rain and everything. Post-processing on medium, foliage medium. Textures I have on high. I like to see the cars really, really well designed. 120 meters for the mirror view, low 45, medium. You can use it low. It's almost the same thing. And then OpenXR visibility 18. You can decrease depending on your graphic settings. Then here it's not 100. Right now it's disabled because I'm not using VR. But usually I use 150%. Okay, digital to real. 100%. Then materials quality also high because I really like to see the textures of the car, okay, and the materials. Then temporal upscaling, of course, enables, okay, because you are upscaling the image because you are using 50%. And this is the thing, the game is really good on creating the upscaling. Boom quality high because I really like to see the sun and the flares and everything. Then volumetric fog low. There is not there is, if car breaks or something or dust, it's good to have quite a bit of volumetric fog. Then foliage mid, car LOD 65%. Sometimes I put it at 70. It depends on the track, but there is not a lot. There is no much difference between 65 and 70%. HLOD enabled, advanced sharpen filter enabled. Then motion blur, of course, disabled. We don't want motion blur on VR. So that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed. See you soon. Subscribe, click on the bell to receive the notifications. Thank you.